Welcome to the Gemini era. Today, Google's pulling the curtain off their eagerly awaited Gemini Ultra model. Let's take a trip down memory lane to December, when Gemini's announcement hinted at an advanced model that was set to redefine state of the art. Indeed, with industry-leading performance and 30 out of 32 benchmarks, Gemini has not only reached but exceeded the state of the art. Until this momentous day, the Gemini Pro model has been the go-to choice in Google's Bard or Google Cloud's Vertex AI. Now, the landscape is shifting. A captivating blog post discusses the excitement surrounding the Gemini Ultra release. For instance, third-party assessors apparently crowned Gemini Ultra in the Gemini Advanced service as the champion chatbot, outshining rivals like ChatGPT-4. As of today, Gemini Ultra is accessible in most territories and countries, and in English, but there's a catch. It's exclusive to non-work Google accounts. Saying yes to the Google One AI Premium plan for $19.99 per month unlocks the doors to Gemini Advanced, backed by the power of Gemini Ultra. There's a two-month trial and perks like 2 terabytes of Google Drive storage, along with coming soon AI features in Gmail, Google Drive, and Google Docs. Furthermore, Android and iOS users rejoice. Gemini's arrival as a mobile app means everyone has a taste of this cutting-edge model that's giving GPT-4 some serious competition. These plans pique your interest? Following the link in the blog post to the Gemini Advanced page reveals the trial and subscription signup. Again, certain constraints like your country, usage of a work account, or age may deny access. So, for now, we'll switch to a personal Gmail. Let's dive deeper to explore the signup journey, test the user experience, and compare versus OpenAI. Accessed via a personal account, the trial offer is displayed clearly with pricing details of Gemini Ultra within the Google One AI Premium plan. Next up is the subscription. You'll need to provide some payment info, but fear not, cancel anytime within the trial phase for a no-strings-attached test run. Upon entering the requisite information and hitting subscribe, you're in. Now, let's shift gears and dive into Gemini Advanced to discover the thrilling capabilities that lie ahead. The Gemini Advanced web app is just a flavor of the same Bard service from before. Just make sure to select the correct model: Gemini, powered by Gemini Pro, or Gemini Advanced, powered by Gemini Ultra. You can see the old model on this tab. As is the case with many of these personal tier LLM services, our conversations could potentially be used to improve the model. So I wouldn't put any particularly sensitive data into these prompts. Unless you're using specifically an enterprise service, you should avoid putting sensitive data into LLM prompts. Now, for an exciting head-to-head comparison, we'll compare this to the other LLM titan, OpenAI's ChatGPT-4. With that service, you're also going to pay about $20 a month to get the best model, which is GPT-4. So the Google offering is priced quite competitively, especially since they're adding in some extra bonuses like the 2 terabytes of storage and Google Workspace AI features. Again, we're going to pause the video here and input the payment data for the subscription, and then we'll get our head-to-head comparison. Be sure, if you're doing comparisons yourself, that you're comparing as close to apples as you can, and that would mean using GPT-4, the best model that OpenAI has, against Google's leading model, Gemini Ultra, via the Gemini Advanced service. For this lightning round head-to-head battle, we're going to focus on a number of quick questions, and since you'll want to just play with this yourself for your own use cases, we'll keep this pretty brief. So let's ask a factual knowledge and reasoning type of question to Gemini Advanced. On this first question, we get a pretty well-structured and appropriate answer. We even stumble upon this, think of it this way, slice of the answer, which adds a nice bit of empathy and emotion. It's not just handing you the facts, but trying to thoughtfully contextualize and explain them. This all looks promising. Now you may have spotted the highlighted text labeled "Understand the results." That's a nifty little verification method where it checks Google search to see if similar content aligns with our answer. In essence, it's cross-checking or grounding its outputs against Google search. Both affirming and contradicting search results are highlighted, flagged in green and brown, respectively. Additionally, when you delve deeper, you'll find some pretty slick citations like this. You can also listen to the answers audibly, examine various drafts of the answer, or verify the response with Google search. And that's not all. There's an option for you to tweak responses too. From shortening or expanding to making it simpler, casual, or even more professional, tailoring your answer style to your personal preference. Now let's throw the same challenge at GPT-4, shall we? As expected, we receive a similar and appropriate response. However, we don't see the grounding checks here. Also, there's certainly less interactivity available with this response. You'll find options like regenerate and other features, but some nice Gemini Advanced response controls are not matched here. So, on to step two, and let's present another query. This time, a deeply subjective one. Can it compose a brief poem for us? Looking at the response through a format-based lens, it indeed looks promising. If you'd fancy a break to make a personal evaluation of the model's literary prowess, go ahead and pause the video. Now let's do the very same with a new session on ChatGPT. Interestingly, ChatGPT hops straight to the answer, a trait we find appealing. Truth be told, the preambles in LLMs, although painfully common, can sometimes be a bit annoying, especially when integrating these LLMs into applications, pipelines, or scripts. Now, for our next quest, let's start a cross-LLM debate. Does social media do more good than harm for society? We'll need a justification for the opinions presented. Of course, there are safety, bias, and sensitive topic measures in place in both models, so don't be thrown aback if you encounter a non-response. However, this time we got a comprehensive reply. According to Gemini Ultra, the perks of social media are connectivity, expression, awareness, access to information, and business opportunities, all reasonable points. The downside? Mental health impact, misinformation, polarization, addiction, time wasting, and privacy issues, making it clear that it's a complex issue with no simple answer. Let's lob the same query to ChatGPT. You may notice similarity in their responses. Both curated a list of positives, connectivity and awareness, access to information and business opportunities, and negatives from polarization and privacy to mental health concerns and productivity issues. And the final word? As we all know, it depends. Ready for the final showdown? Brace up for a thrilling duel. We'll be looking at a couple examples of code generation. Remember, both models crisply handle multimodality, accommodating things like images, natural language, and code. So let's challenge the models to write us Python scripts. On the first task, Gemini displays some competence issues, or at least hesitance, and holds off on generating code for us. This isn't common, but it does seem like Google's model is more cautious about potential hallucinations, and you'll occasionally get non-answers. On the side of ChatGPT, we see some behind-the-scenes integrations at play, along with some code. ChatGPT's relative confidence backfires a bit with an unexpected error, but rather than leaving us high and dry, it arms us with code to at least get started with. Ready for round two? With lightning speed, we get some freshly baked Python code. As a nice bonus, we even get some slick output integrations. We can bring this straight into Colab and let the magic happen. Indeed, the output is as expected. There's probably some sort of Python interpreter or calculator agent nestled within the Gemini Advanced system, given how structured and precise the answer appears to be. Now let's take ChatGPT for a spin. We meet the same Vader tool within NLTK, but it gives us a bit more setup steps and preamble. We're handed these two separate blocks, which we can piece together for a solution. And voila, we've carved out a working code once again. A side-by-side evaluation reveals uncanny similarities in coding. From our download process to the sentiment intensity analyzer, using polarity scores and printing the result, the code successfully crosses the finish line in both races. The one-click export ability to platforms like Colab makes Gemini a pretty smooth and seamless experience, particularly for Python code. Now, if you swear by benchmarks, that will pretty quickly determine the best model for you. A thorough examination of these markers across different areas can guide you in choosing a model for your unique endeavor. For example, on paper, Gemini Ultra holds an edge over GPT-4 in Python code generation, as evidenced by two standard benchmarks. Benchmarks definitely have their limitations and issues, though, so we'd suggest giving the models an actual test drive. In contrast, GPT-4 steals the spotlight in just a couple of benchmarks, like Heliswag. From our lens, both are powerhouse LLMs, and there's no clear winner. Gemini Advanced seems differentiated in its integrations, grounding, citations, and user experience, but it's tougher to discern superiority across the two LLMs when it comes to the quality of outputs. The best judge truly is your personal journey. Consider running your own tests to find your match. Given how powerful both of these models are, I really don't think you can go wrong either way. On that note, we hope that you found this video helpful. Please do share your thoughts, questions, and wild theories in the comment section, where we'll happily join you in the conversation. Thanks so much for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.